In today's video, I'm going to show you how to be able to stream vertically to YouTube Shorts utilizing OBS Studio. So once you have OBS open, on the right-hand side, you're going to select Settings. You're then going to come to Stream, and for Service, you want to make sure you have YouTube RTMPS selected. You go ahead and get connected to your YouTube account. Now, if you've never live streamed to YouTube before, you're going to want to first come to your YouTube account on a browser. You're going to come to the right-hand side and select Create, and then you want to select Go Live. Now, if you've never done this before, you're going to get a prompt that's going to say you have to wait 24 hours before you're able to live stream, and then you'll be able to be good to go. If you see the screen that I see now where it says Welcome to the new YouTube Live Control Room, then you are able to live stream directly on YouTube. So once you go ahead and got that sorted, you're going to come back to OBS. We're going to select Ignore Streaming Service Setting Recommendations. Then we're going to come here to where it says Output. And here for your video encoder, these are going to be the best settings to get the best quality possible on your YouTube Shorts live stream when utilizing OBS Studio. So here for the video encoder, if you're on a Mac, you'll use Hardware Encoder. If you're on a Windows, you'll use NVIDIA. Then we'll have here for the rate control, CBR. And then for the bit rate, I have it at 9,000. You can have it between 6,000, 9,000 for a 1080p stream. Now, the way you figure out this number is by understanding your upload speed. In order for you to be able to support a 9,000 bit rate, you want to have at least 20 upload on your internet. So to be able to check that, you're going to come to speedtest.net, and I'll put a link in the description of this video. You'll simply press go, and then it's going to give you your download and your upload. You want this upload number to be at least 20. Anything higher than 20, you should be good to be able to stream at 9,000. So once you have that figure there, you're going to come back to OBS. For keyframe intervals, you're going to put it at 2 seconds. For profile, you're going to put it at high, and then you can go ahead and select use B frames. So the next thing we want to do is to be able to stream vertically to OBS, we need to make sure that our canvas in OBS is set up correctly. So we'll come to video. And for the base canvas, you want to make sure that it's set to 1080 by 1920. So you can simply go ahead and type that in, 1080 by 1920. And then you want the output to be exactly the same, 1080 by 1920. And then your FPS can be at 60. So now you'll press OK, and we'll have this vertical landscape here now. So now we want to do is we want to go ahead and build it out and start adding the things that are going to make our vertical live stream look professional. So the first thing that we're going to want to do, and we're going to end up creating something similar like this here. So what you're going to want to do here is you want to hit this little plus icon under sources. We're first going to start with our camera. So to be able to add our camera, we're going to go video capture device. You can go ahead and add in your camera. I have it here selected. Press OK. And now you can see here that my camera is not going to be in shape. So I'm going to grab it. I'm going to bring it down, and that's going to be the first stage of it. The next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to bring in a starting soon screen. So what I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to hit plus on here. I'm going to go to media source, and I already have a starting soon screen right here. I'm going to press OK. And now I'm going to bring this down and also resize it. Okay. And this is going to be a starting soon that I went ahead and got from streamdesigns.com. And I'll put a link in the description of this video. So Stream Designs has tons of overlay packages you can go ahead and utilize to make your stream look professional. The one that you see here is the package loadout. So you can see here that this is going to bring everything that I need to be able to make my stream look professional, from my starting soon, from my be right back, from my countdown timer, from my alert, my overlays, everything that I need to make my stream look professional. And again, I'll put a link in the description to Stream Designs in the description below. So once you go ahead and have your overlays, you'll then be able to go ahead and start adding them in here just like this. So I have my camera, then I'll have my starting soon, and then I want to go ahead and add in my gameplay. So to be able to do that, I'm going to hit the plus icon. I'm going to hit video capture device. I already have my gameplay already added here, so I'm going to grab that. Here's my PlayStation screen. I'm going to bring it down just slightly, and then I'll be able to go ahead and adjust it. And here what I'll do is that I'll make this a little bit bigger. And then I'll right click on this, select transform, and then I will go ahead and hit center horizontally. And now here we are. I now have my camera at the top. I now have my starting soon in the middle, and then I have my gameplay here, and you can adjust this exactly however you like. Now, once you have your layout ready to go, you then want to go ahead and come to the right-hand side, select Manage Broadcast, and now here's where we want to go ahead and create a new broadcast. So we want to go ahead and add in my title. So this is a test stream. You then want to input your description. This could be you put your links to your other socials. You can put more things about what it is you're going to be streaming. This is a test. And then very important here for privacy. If you want everyone to be able to see your vertical live streaming, you want it to pop up on the shorts feed, you want to make sure you have this selected at public. If you just want to be able to test to see how it looks, you can go unlisted or private. So I'm going to leave it as unlisted. You're then going to select your category for gaming. And then it says this video made for kids. Now, if your content is kids content, right? Like it's going to be, you're just going to be playing kids games. Then you want to go ahead and say, yes, it's made for kids. But most of the time, if you want anybody to be able to watch your content, you want to select no, it's not made for kids. Then you want to go ahead and add in a thumbnail. And if you've never created a gaming thumbnail before, I'll put a link in the description of this video to how to make a gaming thumbnail. Then you can go ahead and for latency, you can leave it at normal or you can leave it at low. Okay. And then you want to enable DVR. And then you want to go ahead and select create broadcast and start streaming. And that's going to send it over to YouTube. Now, if you want to be able to stream in both vertical and horizontal to maybe like Twitch and YouTube Shorts or YouTube long form, and then also YouTube Shorts or even TikTok, go ahead and watch this video right here where I walk you step by step on how to stream both in horizontal and in vertically at the same time utilizing OBS Studio. I'll see you guys in the next video.